So now we are going to discussing about this differential global questioning system. So in that, up to now we discussed about this control signal. We discussed about the GPS segmentations. GPS segmentations and satellite constellation and determination of time delay in the receiving. So now we need to discuss about this P code is normally very difficult to match because of its very length. It's very long length. So it has a period of 267 days, but only 7-day portions of it are assigned to different satellites. The P code is normally very difficult to match. The P code is normally very difficult to match because of its very long length, and it has a period of 267 days, but only 7-day portion of it are assigned to different satellites. Therefore, we have 37 different P codes. Therefore, we have 37 different P codes since the one week signals assigned do not overlap with the P code of any other satellites. Therefore, the navigation information and other data are modulated on the carrier at rate of 50 bits per second. Navigation information and other data are modulated on the carrier at a rate of 50 bits per second. This is termed the decode. This message contains information on the satellite ephemeris, satellite identification, satellite clock parameters, status of the GPS, system time, and so on. So this decode message contains the information. It contains information on satellite ephemeris, satellite identification, satellite clock parameters, status of the GPS, system time, and so on. So we already saw the table 2.1, which will be gives the a summary of characteristics of GPS signals. Which will be give the summary of characteristics of the GPS signals. So the GPS measures data. GPS measures are the GPS measurement. The GPS measurement data 50 bits per second, 1500 bits, knowing the position of the GPS satellites at any time as well as the associated clocker provided by a decode, and measuring the range from the user to the satellite, we can deduce that the user's position, will lie on the surface of a space center at the satellite. By measuring three ranges to three satellites simultaneously, the user position can be determined by the user's position can be determined by the intersection of three space centered at each satellite. By measuring three ranges to three satellites simultaneously, the user's position can be determined by the intersection of three space centered at each satellite. since the user does not usually carry a precision atomic clock, since the user or the receiver does not usually carry a precision satellite, sorry, a precision atomic clock. Another unknown is added to the computations, that is the user clock bias from GPS system time. The user's clock bias from GPS system time. Therefore, three range measurements are required for position determination x, y, z. And one of the user clock bias. Therefore, three range measurements are required for the position determination in x and y, z directions. And one of the user clock bias, one should at least observe four satellites simultaneously. One should at least observe four satellites. Four satellites simultaneously. You need to see here, use it to compute a complete XYZ. This means that a three-dimensional fix by solving a system of four equations with four unknown parameters, with four unknowns, 17. So we already saw that in the previous diagrams. So this absolutely three-dimensional position, which can be referred to any appropriate selected coordinate system. One fundamental geometric system applicable to satellite positioning is the Earth fixed. Earth-centered reference system is called the World Geodetic System 1972. World Geodetic System 1972, or we need to call WGS-72. World Geodetic System. So the World Geodetic System 72, as we saw in the 2.6, is characterized by the following properties. The first one is, the x-axis passes through the intersection of the equator and the Greenwich meridian. You saw that already. You need to see that. Here you see the x-axis passes through center of the earth and Greenwich meridian. Okay. And what about y? Sorry, you need to see the Z. Okay. What about Z? Tell me. So the Z-axis passes through the North Pole. Z-axis passes through the North Pole. And the Y-axis completes the right-handed coordinate system. So the condition of simultaneity of range measurements requires that there is no mutual reference of the GPS satellite signals of the GPS satellite signals. So this is one of the properties. This is one of the properties of the spread spectrum technique. This is the one of the properties of the spread spectrum techniques. And this is one of the major reason. This is one of the major reasons used for the selection of this system type or selection of this type of signal. So in reality, the basic GPS measurement is not a direct geometric distance. The basic GPS measurement is not a direct geometric distance from the user to the satellite. It is not direct geometric distance, okay, from the receiver to the satellite, but a range in terms of raw receiver measurement, a range in terms of raw receiver measurement, which includes atmospheric delays and user clock bias. A range in terms of raw receiver measurement, which includes atmospheric delays and user clock bias. This is termed a pseudo range observation because the satellite themselves are in motion. The system allows us to measure. Another inherently complementary quantity. That is integrated Doppler data. Hence, two types of navigation data are available. Through the GPS system. Pseudo ranges and integrated Doppler data. Those two data, two types of navigation data are pseudo ranges and integrated Doppler data. The pseudo range rate. Here we have two types of navigation data are available through the GPS system: pseudo range and integrated Doppler data. This allows the user to compute a three-dimensional position velocity. And time information. At present, horizontal accuracies of 20 meters CPE have been obtained. Using C by A code only. And less than 10 meters CPE using the P code. by 1987, 18 satellites will be placed in the orbit. 1987, 18 satellites will be placed. 18 satellites will be placed in orbit, and a two-dimensional accuracy of 25 meters, and the two-dimensional accuracy of 25 meters are less than a 95% probability, and less than a 95% probability are 10 meters CP will be provided continuously. So by 1987, 18 satellites will be placed in orbit, and a two-dimensional accuracy of 25 meters or less with a 95% probability, a 10 meters CPU will be provided continuously. 10 meters CPU will be provided continuously. So the U.S. Department of Defense, plans to degrade the accuracy of both the P code and CIA code signals. The U.S. Department of Defense plans to degrade the accuracy of both the P code and the C by A code. According to the Federal Radio Navigation Plan, two kinds of accuracies will be provided to unauthorized civil users, for whom self we are going to provide two kinds of accuracies to unauthorized civil users. So the U.S. Department of Defense plans to degrade the accuracy of both P code and CYA code signals, according to the Federal Radio Navigation Plan. Two kinds of accuracies will be provided to unauthorized civil users. So the precise positioning service, PPS, precise positioning service and standard positioning service, PPS, SPS. These are the to unauthorized civil users. So the PPS will be provide two dimensional accuracies of 18 meters or 2D RMS. The precise positioning service will be provide two dimensional accuracies of 18 meters or 2D RMS, whereas the SPS accuracies will be 500 meters or 2D RMS. Standard positioning service will be provided accuracy around will be 500 meters or 2D RMS only. So the accuracy figure 2D RMS is a multiple of the CPU. According according to the definition given in the Federal Radio Navigation Plan. According to the definition given in the Federal Radio Navigation Plan. 2D RMS is 2.5 times greater than CPE. This means that 2.5 into CPE. So according to the definition given in the Federal Radio Navigation Plan, 2D RMS is 2.5 times greater than CPU, 2.5 into CPU. So the comparison with the other radio navigation systems, the comparison with the other radio navigation systems, the GPS actually evolved in response to a need for a worldwide. The GPS actually evolved in response to a need for a worldwide, all-weather, accurate radio navigation system, and as a constraint to the proliferation of radio navigation systems. The actual GPS evolved in response to a need for a worldwide, all-weather, accurate radio navigation system, and as a consequence to the proliferation of radio navigation systems. Let us review some of the major radio navigation systems. That exist today and compare them with GPS. So the table 2.2 shows some of the existing radio navigation systems. Which are used for marine applications of positioning. Navigation with their maximum coverage and accuracy. This existing radio navigation system used for marine applications of positioning and navigation with their maximum coverage and accuracy. It was difficult to construct a table that would express the accuracy figures on the same probability level, that is 50 meters with 95% probability. So in the table 2.2, it represents the most recent available information only. So in that we have most recent information only. Generally, all short-range radio navigation systems, are confined to line of sight operation to line of sight operation, and in addition to that require the installation of several show stations. Generally, all short range radio navigation systems are confined to line of sight operation, and in addition to that requires the installation of several show stations. Hence, they are not useful for distance offshore work. Worldwide coverage is not fulfilled. Let us briefly discuss the three long range navigation systems. Which can provide worldwide coverage. So these systems are the LoRaG, the Omega, the LoRaG, the Omega, and the Transit. These are the three long range navigation systems: LoRaG, Omega, and Transit. Some factories influencing the performance of these systems. Their limitations and the additional capabilities of GPS that cannot be fulfilled by the above system are examined. So the LoRaG is primarily a ground-based navigation. Because of the atmospheric or because of the atmosphere, one major system problem arises. That is propagation error. So the propagation errors are due to a variation in the propagation velocity of the signals. The propagation velocity of the signals. The velocity is actually slowed down by the physical and electrical properties of the edge surface. The edge surface or ground conductivity. These propagation errors amount to 120 meters to 900 meters. The LoRaG coverage is up to 2000 kilometers, and therefore only a small part of the world is provided with positioning. This LoRaG coverage is up to 2000 kilometers, and therefore only a small part of the world is provided with positioning. Whether they also affect the proper functioning of Lorentzi, precipitation or mist contribute errors, in the overall accuracy of the system. A description of some other sources of significant errors. Such as positional reliability. Interference, and so on, can be found in Stansel 23 and ES Coast Guard. A description of some other source of significant errors, such as positional reliability, interference, and so on, can be found in Stansel 23 and the US Coast Guard. This Omega is also ground-based navigation system. But it can satisfy the need for worldwide navigation. The worldwide coverage is provided by the 8 ground transmitting stations. But again, the system suffers from propagation errors. In particular, ionospheric and solar radiation, that is sudden ionospheric disturbances, polar cap disturbances. So these are the some of the ionospheric and solar radiations. So we will get it sometimes sudden ionospheric disturbances from ionospheric, and from solar radiation we'll get it a polar cap disturbances. Okay, in particular, ionospheric and solar radiation render serious errors in the performance of the system. The position errors, amount to appropriate are approximately 2000 meters. Even though the system provides extensive coverage, its reliability is sometimes doubtful. Position error amount to be approximately 2000 meters, even though this system provides extensive coverage. Reliability is sometimes doubtful. Errors of 10 miles, 30 miles, and 100 miles have been noticed. Whether conditions and positional repeatability cause a problem in the performance of the system, as well as transit, also known as US. Weather conditions and positional repeatability cause a problem in the performance of the system, as well transit. also known as the US. Navya navigation satellite system is a satellite based system. It is determines the user's position. This determines the user's position by measuring the Doppler frequency shift of satellite radio signals. It determines the user's position by measuring the Doppler frequency shift of satellite radio signals. A comparison of the transit system with the GPS is given in table 2.3. There are basically three drawbacks in the transit system. The rate of fixes, the large uncertainties in position determination, whether the ship's velocity is unknown, and the interference and jamming of the transit signals themselves. Here, the position determination when the ship's velocity is unknown, and the interference and jamming of the transit signals themselves. A user requires about 10 to 15 minutes to establish his position. The user requires about 10 to 15 minutes time to establish his position. And the maximum fix rate becomes about 5 fixes per hour. Consequently, the transit system provides intermittent coverage, which means not continuous coverage. The system does not appear very useful when the user is moving. An uncertainty of about 1 kilometer or 1 miles per hour of the ship's velocity may be render an error of about 500 meters in position. Since no provisions were taken to avoid interferences among the signals from other transit satellite signals, jamming occur at high latitudes. Where will occur this jamming means? At high latitudes. So this is happening because more than one transit satellite. Appear above the user's origin due to the satellite's polar orbit. So it seems clear that GPS will offer unique capabilities in positioning and navigation and will fulfill the need of worldwide continuous accurate requirements that other radio navigation systems cannot cover. GPS will not offer unique capabilities in positioning and navigation and will fulfill the need of worldwide continuous accurate requirements that other radio navigation systems cannot cover. The GPS promises an outstanding value in navigation. The GPS promises an outstanding value in navigation. According to Federal Radio Navigation Plan, redundant navigation system will be phased out, and only a small number of them will remain in use to cover all navigational requirements. So you need to see the table for that also. Table 2.2, examples of radio navigation systems. This is the table for radio navigation system. This is the transit system, Omega system, Lorenzi. These are the three. Remaining are we have here. Their maximum coverage and position accuracy.